You're confusing, Steve is confusing patriotism with prejudice. And you can envelop nationalism in anything you want. You can even dress white supremacy up in anything you want, and at the end of the day, it's still white supremacy. To get back to Donald Trump and Steve King, Donald Trump campaigned for Steve King and said, he represents our values. Steve King is a racist today, he was a racist yesterday, and he will be a racist tomorrow. He is a scourge on what we try to do in our democracy.
So a day after Democratic Congresswoman Ilhan Omar apologized for tweets that many deemed anti-Semitic, POTUS gave his take.
Her lame apology, and that's what it was lame, and she didn't mean a word of it, was just not appropriate. I think she should resign from Congress, frankly. But at a minimum, she shouldn't be on committees.
The president weighing in on the political future of a freshman Democrat when it was his own, his buddy, his mentor, Congressman Steve King. Here was the president's level of concern.
I haven't been following it. I really haven't been following it.
Been following it? You've known him for years. You're his acolyte. Come on. Bakari Sellers and Steve Cortez. Let's get after it. Bakari Sellers, do you believe the president should have been as vocal about King as he is about Omar? The question, the answer is yes. Why?
Well, he should have been as vocal about King, and he should have been as vocal about other members of his party, whether or not you're talking about McCarthy, who actually used some anti-Semitic tropes himself in tweets back in 2016 when he was running for re-election and trying to get people out to vote. But the president himself has his own racist history. He traffics in racism. Steve King is a racist. And so it's ironic, and I don't think people take seriously what he says when he criticizes Congresswoman Omar. Let me say this, though. Her comments were anti-Semitic. Her comments were ignorant and do not deserve to be heard in our discourse at that level. And what I mean by that is AIPAC is an organization that does not spend within the top 50 in lobbying funds at the United States Congress.
Fair point.
When you look at the fact that it's bipartisan, her comments make the nuanced conversation that we have to have about Israel in the peace process more difficult.
Should she be removed from committees?
Man, hell no. You can chastise Bibi Netanyahu. You can talk about the way law enforcement treats Ethiopians and other Africans in Israel. That's fair. You can even talk about settlements. That's fair and be critical. But you cannot delve into anti-Semitic tropes.
No, I agree. It wasn't even a trope. It was direct. There was no suggestion. There was no implicit. It wasn't a trope. It was direct. But what I'm asking is Democrats said Steve King should be off the committees. They agreed with the Republicans. Why not here?
Well, Steve King has a history. This is not anything new. This young lady's been in Congress not 2 or 3 months, and I do have a sincere problem with her. I do have a sincere problem with her comments. I will say this, though. I believe that many Republicans need to sit this one out. Donald Trump has no moral high ground here, and Nancy Pelosi did what she should do. This young lady apologized. She seems sincere in her apology. She wants to learn, and let's move
Bakari,
forward.
Bakari, Steve King's
That's
not staying
true
out of it. He doesn't want to let that new look go to waste. Don't think I didn't see it. Don't think
hey,
I didn't see it smooth.
It's winter time. I hope
I
you like
you
it
got
my
cooking.
My wife does not like it, so it might not last. We'll see.
It won't last long.
Listen, it is just not true that she doesn't have a history. She absolutely has a documented social media history. She had to apologize, in fact, for a previous tweet
not
where
the first
she called
time.
Israel, where she called it evil. I mean, listen, that's not talking policy. And she said that Israel had, quote, hypnotized the world. That's when we're delving into actual anti-Semitism rather than actual criticism of Israel, which, of course, is fine from a policy perspective. So and the idea, by the way, that she shouldn't be removed from her committees, just as Steve King was, both of them were trafficking in hate. Both of them equally wrong. And I think both of them should face the same consequence. But here's the other difference is, Bakari, you said that she seems sincere in her apology. Here's why I don't believe that, because unlike Steve King, who his crimes were bad enough, okay, but he didn't double and triple down as she is set to appear on February 23rd in Florida for the Islamic Relief USA event. She's going to be on with Youssef Abdallah. This is a man who on social media called, quote, beautiful, the killing of Jews in Israel and the rocket bombing of Tel Aviv. She will share a podium and share a stage with that kind of a merchant of hate. That tells me she is not remotely sorry.
I don't know what she plans on doing in her future other than the words that she said. But my pushback will be this. twofold to you. One is that Steve King has a history of racism. He even has Confederate flags on his desk. That's first. And second, I think that Chris started out by saying that the President of the United States, should he be interjecting himself into this? And I, while I appreciate whether or not we can find sincerity in the apology of Representative Omar, my question to you is, where's the apology from Donald Trump to the Central Park Five? Where's the apology from Donald Trump to the individuals he discriminated against in housing? Where's the apology from Donald Trump when you talk about the casino dealers in Atlantic City? Where's the apology to those individuals who come into this country to find a better life, but Donald Trump characterizes them as rapists? So my point to you is simply this. Donald Trump and the Republican Party do not have the high ground. I will give you this, though, Steve. We have a problem in this country with the rise of anti-Semitism. We have a problem in this country with the rise of racism and hate. It does not belong in the discourse of this country. And as a Democrat, I can say Congressman Omar was wrong. I challenge you to say Donald Trump was wrong, because as we say down south, what's good for the goose is good for the gander.
Well, let's reframe it a little bit, Steve. The president said nothing about Steve King. Okay, there was a lot of attention, a lot of momentum around it. The left, the media, and then the right. Okay, McCarthy, to his credit, came out, took action against the guy. All of Congress took action against the president. Never said a word. Literally, the cliche. The silence was deafening. Why? Why was that allowed by your party?
To his discredit, he should have said it. But I will also say this.
Why didn't
he? One reason perhaps he didn't is because the Republican Party on the Hill disciplined its own. So to some extent, he didn't have to.
He comments on everything. Why not that?
He didn't need to intervene.
Yes, he did.
The House stripped him and neutered him. He's totally ineffectual now in the
never
House. He
has nothing. Gauges and his responses that way, Steve.
Hold on. And the Democrats have not done that, by the way. They have not done that with Representative Omar, and they need to. This is a blot on them. This is an anti-Semitic blot on them, and the fact
Democrats
that they won't discipline her the same way that King was disciplined by the Republicans.
But why should the president talk about Omar and not King?
Because my point, Chris, is that she has not been disciplined by her own party. There has been no consequence to her in reality. She's planning on sharing the stage with a sympathizer with terrorism, with Hamas, with Muslim Brotherhood.
All right, I hear your point. Go ahead, Bob.
I cannot speak to that. I have no information on that. I don't know that to be true or false. I can't sit here and lie to the American public and speak to that. But what I can simply say, though, is that Nancy Pelosi on down in leadership, and even me as a progressive Democrat in the South, we will all stand up and say that was anti-Semitic. We will all stand up and say you have lessons to learn about Israel. You have lessons to learn, as I said earlier today on another show, about what's going on in a kibbutz in Sderot, all the way up to what's going on in Tel Aviv and everywhere in between. And we can ask you to apologize, but we can also say that this is a learning moment, not just for you, Congressman Omar, but for everyone. And we're going to make sure we hold you to that. I don't see what's wrong with that when we're trying to move this country forward and have a discourse about these
hateful
rhetoric.
But it can't be just apology. It has to be apology and consequences, as it was for Steve King, as it should have been for Steve King. Why can't it be the same for her? Why is she not stripped of her committee assignments? Why is she not being not just forced to apologize, but actually forced to suffer consequences in her career, legislative, professional?
I just wonder if you guys don't lose the high ground. Steve, I'm with you on the logic, right? It's just in what they call in the law, pari passu, right? You're walking in the same steps, the same path for both. Equal.
Right.
But your problem is that you lose it on the president. And Bakari articulately laid out his own personal past. I'll give you a pass on that for the sake of argument. And I'm saying when you guys didn't say, Mr. President, we're coming after Steve King and for good reason, lift your voice, tweet, do what you do best, weigh in on something that is a potential outrage. And he didn't. He never has. Silence, deafening, unexplained.
I mean, but Chris, but this is as I'm sorry. Go ahead, Steve.
Chris, as I already said, I concede. Yes, I wish he had. I wish he had. But I'm also grateful. And perhaps the reason he didn't is the fact that the Republican Party took care of discipline.
Or does he
on
agree with Steve King
on the Hill? And we haven't seen.
Or does he agree with Steve?
By the way, in your introduction, Chris, you called him his mentor and you called Trump his acolyte. That's really unfair.
I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why.
That's not unfair.
In 7 seconds, Tom Tancredo was the mentor for Steve King. Steve King took up that border xenophobic deal. Trump went early on out to see him, wound up picking up that issue shortly thereafter and adopting similar rhetoric. They both used the term nationalist to explain themselves to America.
I use the term. I use the term nationalist.
But even more
because
importantly,
you're trying
even
to
more directly,
I'm an American. With blood of I'm an American nationalist, and America
listen,
has nothing to do with race. We
listen,
are an idea.
Nationalism
and a country, not a race.
Is a
listen,
dangerous
you,
thing that we have seen
yeah,
abused
you can be a nationalist all you want,
and is a perverse
I
dispensary of humanity in the past.
American nationalism is about shared values and our Constitution, and
listen,
it has nothing
you
to
can,
do with race.
That's called
you're
patriotism.
Multiracial.
That's patriotism.
You're confusing.
You need to learn what that word means and how it's been used in the past, and you know it. Don't protect everything this president does. Go ahead, Bakari.
You're confusing. Steve is confusing patriotism with prejudice, and you can envelop nationalism in anything you want. You can even dress white supremacy up in anything you want, and at the end of the day, it's still white supremacy. To get back to Donald Trump and Steve King, Donald Trump campaigned for Steve King and said he represents our values. Steve King is a racist today, he was a racist yesterday, and he will be a racist tomorrow. He is a scourge on what we try to do in our democracy. But even more importantly, Donald Trump is the same person who went to Charlottesville and said there are good people on both sides. He is the same person who had to stand up and literally say, who is David Duke? So my only point is that Donald Trump traffics in racism, and Steve King is a racist, and they belong together.
There's too many things for me to address because we're out of time, but he completely rebuked David Duke. That's not true. The fact that David Duke endorsed him does not mean that Trump endorses David Duke.
He said, I don't know who that is.
Well, took him a long time to get to it.
That,
we don't have the time to get into it now. We
totally
don't need to go back. We've got a situation in the present right now, but the past is prologue, right? He's had this thing dogging him, and we have to look at why. Bakari, Steve, well argued, and thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
All right, big night.
Donald Trump campaigned for Steve King and said he represents our values. Steve King is a racist today, he was a racist yesterday, and he will be a racist tomorrow. He is a scourge on what we try to do in our democracy.